Salut tout le monde and welcome to Bambi Patterns, y'all beautiful people. The first measurement is your hip circumference. Second, your waist circumference. The third is the back width. The fourth is the depth of your front neckline. The fifth is your nape of the neck to the waist. And the sixth is your shoulder length. And last and not least is the dress length. To cut the back and the front simultaneously, the width is 148 centimeters. This includes 1 centimeter seam allowance on each side. The length to fold is 42 centimeters and it includes 1 centimeter seam allowance at the top and 2 centimeter hem allowance. Follows the same process. Fold the fabric to cut the back and front simultaneously. The width is 80 centimeters. This includes 1 centimeter seam allowance on each side. The length to fold is 47 centimeters and it includes 1 centimeter seam allowance to join the waist and 1 centimeter to join the third pattern. The three pleats are 5 centimeters wide, meaning 2.5 centimeters will be folded in on either side. With the outer pleats on either side being half pleats of 3 centimeters wide. Once the skirt waistline has been pleated, it should align in width with the bodice waistline. So for example, if the bodice waistline as per the pattern is 94 centimeters, then this pattern waistline should measure the same with the pleats. The placement of the pockets on the middle pattern, measure 9 centimeters from the waistline where the pocket will be attached. Thereafter, measure 19 centimeters from this point, which indicates the placement of the pockets. you'll need to cut 4 pocket patterns. The pocket is 18 centimeter wide. The side length is 19 centimeters, but when you include 1 centimeter seam allowance at the top and 1 centimeter seam allowance at the bottom, this equates to 21 centimeters that you see on the screen. Take your third pattern pieces, join the back and the front by sewing the sides. Take your pocket pattern pieces and join them together.
So this is the middle part, you keep like this, so I've just pushed it, okay? This is the pocket which is already overlocked. So now the pocket has got seam allowance, because this is the inside, it's got seam allowance. Okay? So what, the pocket will lie like this, inward, okay? But we need to actually sew this to that, but one side only. So the one side that we're going to sew when we push it this way is actually going to be wrong to this. So basically, right side here, so both wrong side needs to be showing. So it's gonna be the right side and this top part, right side. We're going to match it where we put the 9 centimeters, so 1 centimeter above the 9 centimeters. So it's there. So basically, it is you're going to match it where it starts at 8 centimeters. Okay. So again, that's how the pocket is. So I'm taking this side. I'm leaving it that. I'm taking this side and I'm just matching it. I'm going to overlock it first. Right. Okay. So now you can see it's wrong side, right side to right side on the top. So if I flip it like this, you'll be able to see that this is how your pocket is going to look, because it's going to fold this. And you're going to do the same. So we're going to overlock. First, we're going to overlock this. Okay. And then we're going to join them later. We're going to join from here to there. Basically, we're going to join the seam allowance here. Like that. Up to there. And then we're also going to join this part from here. Today, okay, but this will be inside when we join it. Okay, so to be like this when we join it. Okay, to be like this. So if I flip it on this side, you can see the pocket has been created. We can put our hand in our pocket. Okay. And so this is how it looks. Okay, and what I did basically is one side, you took one side, so there's this the difference. This is overlocked to the pocket of one side, and then you flip, and then this is overlocked to the other side seam allowance, okay, forming the pocket in the middle. Okay, now what we're going to do is, because this is already done, see, this is how it looks. What we're going to do now is we're going to sew the side seam. Okay, so we're going to sew 1 centimeter from here to there. We're going to join this part, and we're going to join this part 1 centimeter. So if you measure 1 centimeter in, like 1 centimeter in, to be like that, and then you fold it again 1 centimeter in, and that is how the hem will be. Okay. We're doing the gathering. I've already done the gathering from one side. So what I did is I looked at where the seam allowance is, and this is the seam allowance. You can see. So from the seam allowance, one side, and I gathered it to the next side seam allowance. Okay. Using your biggest stitch, stitch two lines about 1 centimeter apart, just two lines, you can see two thread lines, 1 centimeter apart, the whole round, okay? Then after that, you're gonna take the bobbin thread. So the bobbin thread will be the one inside. So you take the bobbin thread, which is this, and then the other one is this, and then using these two bobbin thread, you start pulling. You see, as you pull the bobbin thread, it creates that gathered look. So I'm just gonna pull until it becomes like the other side.
With the gathering done, it's time to join the bottom and middle patterns. Once joined, sew them together. All right, beautiful people. So we've gotten to the bodice pattern, and I'm going to let the pattern do all the talking. I have included a detailed diagram of the Dolman short sleeve that I am drawing. starting to add 1 centimeter seam allowance all around, with the exception of the center back. I'm cutting out the pattern now. To make the front, adjust the back pattern.
So we're going to measure down 15 centimeters just from the we're going to add 1 centimeter seam allowance all around. So this is still the same. So this is the front, thighs, back. Okay, and we're going to square it off. Depending on how we will see if we want it to be lower, but for now I'm just going to leave it there. So, and now when we cut the front, what we're going to do is we're just going to fold this like this, and then we have the front. So this will be center back plus center front. Okay, alright, and then we're going to be cut. Oops, cut on fold. Okay. So we're going to be cutting it on fold and yeah. Alright. So that's it. It cut our front and it cut our back.
Join the front and the back bodice pieces by sewing the shoulders and the side seam. to sew the sleeve hem, fold it 5 cm and another 5 cm, pin and sew around. Join the bodice to the skirt and sew. Insert an elastic of the same circumference as the waist and sew that in the waistline seam. Time to sew the bias binding to the neckline, starting at the back and working our way back to the starting point. Sew in the folded line all around, then turn it over and top stitch 0.5 mm against the wrong side of the fabric. The belt included is 1.8 meters long and 1.3 centimeters wide. And voila, the finished product. The pleats on the Dolman short sleeve maxi pleated dress look so beautiful.